What's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel where we learn, do, and talk about photography until we're sick of it. As promised in last week's video, I'm here at the Covered Bridge at Cataract Falls State Recreation Area. Cataract Falls, if you will recall from that video, is the largest waterfall by volume in the state of Indiana. And today I've got something of a covered bridge adventure planned out because after we shoot this covered bridge, we'll be moving on to a covered bridge festival, the Park County Covered Bridge Festival, which is the largest festival in the state of Indiana. All perfect opportunities to seize the autumnal scenery, the change of seasons, and appreciate the explosion of color that's happening here in the state of Indiana. So I would swear that I've stumbled into something that some other photographer has set up for me. I've got a great framing here to the covered bridge. Maybe could use a little bit better of a sky today, but with the backlight, what can you do? And a nice fallen maple branch here, stripped of all its bark, nice bright white accent down at the bottom of the frame to lead us into this scene. So I really appreciate the occlusion of it. It feels like a very small, tight, intimate scene, despite the fact that I'm in a wide open a wide open field right here next to a parking lot in a park. So you would think that this was something you stumbled on where, you know, an individual would enjoy seclusion and privacy if you were just looking at this scene in a photograph. So I appreciate that I've been able to sort of reimagine it in that way. But not too much else to say about it. Polarized, and I've got it for, you know, tenths of a second, so not a long exposure or anything like that. I'll go ahead and capture it. Yeah, that was a quarter of a second at f13, and I just kind of focused halfway through the scene, so just kind of ballparked it. Okay, actually, I've got one more idea. Nice and moist from the morning dew. We'll hit the road and check out what this covered bridge festival is all about. I'm here at the epicenter of the Park County Covered Bridge Festival at the Park County Courthouse in the seat of Park County, Rockville, Indiana. And as you can see, they've transformed the courthouse grounds into a huge vendor area for some delicious smelling food, arts and crafts vendors, and makers of everywhere you could possibly ever want. But I say that this is the epicenter of the festival because the location of the festival proper is actually a number of historic covered bridge sites around Park County. So I don't have time to visit all those sites, and I've stopped here for the purpose of both enjoying this tremendous community activity, but also hopefully getting maybe some information on one covered bridge where I might enjoy winding down this outrageously perfect fall evening, enjoying the scenery, and maybe making a photo. I got my park map. Let's see what I can find. Park map? Park County map. Map of bridges in Park County. Okay, I've got my sights set on this one. The one that's got fall foliage in it. It's like they've already got the picture rearranged for me, so I know exactly what to expect. I think I can get there pretty easily. It doesn't look like it's too far away. Certainly by sunset. And it's, if you're curious, it's located right here next to what I believe is some font that someone forgot to insert on the map. I've arrived at my destination covered bridge, and I must say it is stunning. I struggle for a better description than the regular old cliche, picture perfect. Wow. With the fall colors suiting it perfectly. And, nice. I think I'll just sit here and wait for some nice golden light to fall on this guy, because I don't know that I could capture a better photo than this, maybe anywhere in the state of Indiana or the Midwest. So this gives me a couple hours to take a nap in my car. From flourishing farmland to bustling cities to natural nooks, Indiana is full of charming little scenes, and that's why I'm proud to announce my 2023 Indiana Charms Scenic Photography Calendar. The Indiana Charms Calendar is a beloved gift among homebound and homesick Hoosiers. It brings your love for Indiana imagery inside, and at $14.99, it's the same price as a generic calendar, even though it's made in Indiana and it ships right to your door. But the first 50 pre-orders of the Indiana Charms Calendar are going for $12.99. That's $2 off each calendar at indiana-charms.com. Don't just get organized, get inspired when you order your 2023 Indiana Charms calendar at indiana-charms.com or use the link in the video description. Indiana Charms all year. Okay, 1 hour later after a brief car nap. Is an hour nap brief? How long is an appropriate time of nap? Somebody comment down below. How long of a nap do you take? I usually like an hour and a half, so this was a brief car nap. I've come back to my bridge for what I think is a perfect time, and I'll walk you through the lighting situation and the composition when I go down to take the photo, but I'm just waiting for a motorcycle to pass through the bridge right now. That has been one challenge. Of all the 31 bridges I could have chosen for this as my photo subject tonight, I chose one of probably a handful that are still in service. So that's just been a minor challenge, but it's also been enjoyable to watch the cars pass through, and I enjoyed getting to drive through the bridge myself. Here we go. Okay, I'm kind of in the middle of this road, so it's not the most savory or safe situations. Just behind me, there's a big blind hill with a corner, so I'm going to try to make this quick. You can help me listen for noises, right? So this is roughly the composition that I framed up, and what I want to be sure to include is this dark black trunk here of this tree, and also the black windy branches that come out. I think that's really cool. We've got the bridge, of course. And you'll notice that earlier when I came out, there was light on the face of the bridge. And I thought that I would retain that, but unfortunately, the way the sun is setting behind this hill, there's only a small amount remaining here on the roof. But I like that splash, and there's the foreground is also lit, and we have a little bit of backlight coming through the leaves. So I think the lighting situation is great. I'm glad that I came out earlier than I had intended to, so that I could catch it with what is probably going to be about the last light of the day. Okay, I had a pretty good time experimenting with that one. I took some closer and some further photos than the ones that I gave you a demo of on the video. I shot them with my regular old nifty 50, 50 millimeter f1.8 lens, and that gave me a little bit of slight telephoto compression. Probably have some people to Photoshop out as well, but you'll see the final result that I posted in the video. Got one more stop on our fall foliage photography tour. I think I said it right this time. One more stop on our fall foliage photography tour, and let's just say it's going to be a secret. So be sure you're subscribed to come back and see what the mystery stop is. And until I see you then, you guys keep an eye out and a foot forward. And thank you so much for watching.